I founded the World Technology Network about 15 years ago because I felt that we're on the verge of a change in society that I call a phase change that's beyond any cultural, scientific, economic revolution that we've ever seen. I think we're going to have more change in the next 2 to 3 decades than we've had in the last 2 to 3,000 years. A lot of it driven by science and technology. So I wanted to find a way to identify, not in my opinion, but in the opinion of their peers, who are the people and organizations who are the most innovative in the world. So we do the World Technology Awards every year in partnership with Time Magazine and Fortune Magazine in 20 different categories: IT, hardware, software, biotech, health, energy, materials, space, and related fields ranging from the arts, design, policy, ethics, social entrepreneurship, to identify who are the people who are the most innovative, and it's voted on by their peers. The finalists become the members. We have now 1,000 members in over 40 countries, and we get together for 2 days every year for the World Technology Summit. The new one is coming up on November 13th and 14th here in New York City, and we'd love people to come. They can go to WTN.net to check it out. The reason that I think we need to identify these people and form a community is because the main drivers of change in the 21st century are going to be the kinds of things that they're working on. And they should know each other, and they should also be discussing issues that they can work on together that they may not be aware of, and opportunities. And we play a role, as we say, quote unquote, encouraging serendipity. So we make introductions amongst these people. And also, when people come to our events, they get a chance to have the serendipitous encounters with these people that will lead in positive outcomes that they can't even imagine. It's very exciting, and I love my job. I think I have the best job in the world.